Here's how to set up a triple boot on your Nintendo Switch, allowing you to seamlessly switch between Switchroot Android, L4T Ubuntu, and custom firmware all on one SD card. This guide is fully compatible with the latest versions of Switchroot Android and L4T Ubuntu, so even if you're working with updated software, you're covered. Best of all, you can follow along without losing any of your current setup. Please note that parts of this video have been blurred to comply with YouTube guidelines. First, make a full NAND backup as a safety measure. Then copy your SD card's content to your computer. If you're setting up custom firmware for the first time, back up your save file. Use JKSV to safely store saves. Select New, name your backup, and save it to your computer for easy retrieval. For this setup, I'm using a Samsung Evo Plus 256GB SD card and allocating space like this: 60GB for Switchroot Android, 50GB for L4T Ubuntu, and 29GB for custom firmware. Make sure the card is formatted to FAT32. Programs like GUI Format work great for this step. Download Hecate and Nix and place them in the root directory of your SD card. Connect your Switch to your computer and open Tegra RCM GUI. Put your Switch in recovery mode, inject the Hecate payload, and set the date and time on the device. Open Nix options and select Dump Joy-Con BT. Allocate your space as follows: 60GB for Android, 50GB for Ubuntu, and 29GB for EMU MMC. Once partitioned, reconnect the switch to the computer using USB Tools SD card. For Android, download the tablet version with ARM64 Android 10 Pico. Extract the ICOSA tablet zip file and copy it, along with the GAPS zip file, to your SD card's root. On your switch, go to Partition SD Card, OK, Flash Android, Continue. This will reboot into TWRP. Follow these steps. Mount SD card and select micro SD card. Install the lineage zip file, swipe to confirm, then wipe cache Dalvik. Return to the main menu, install the GAPS zip, and once more wipe cache Dalvik. Reboot, skip Wi-Fi, set up basic settings, and activate developer options by pressing build number 7 times in About Tablet. Turn on Advanced Restart in Developer Options, so you can later reboot into the bootloader. Download L4T Ubuntu 3.2.0 and extract the zip into the root of your SD card. On your switch, go to Partition SD Card, OK, Flash Linux. Afterward, delete the installation files to free up space. Then select L4T Ubuntu Bionic from the home screen. Choose your language, set up the time zone, and create your username and password. Log in and you're good to go. Restart your system and you'll land back in Hecate. In Hecate, go to Create EMU MMC SD Partition Part 1. Once completed, connect to your computer using USB Tools. Then copy sxloader.bin from Tegra RMC GUI into bootloader payloads on your SD backup, renaming it to sxos.bin. In Hecate IPL.ini, add the sxos configuration lines, save the file, and transfer your SD backup back to the SD card. For easy navigation, add custom icons to your Hecate bootloader. Place image files in bootloader RES and reference them in Hecate IPL.ini. For Android, open 00android.ini and add the image file name. For Ubuntu, place the image in Switchroot Ubuntu, then edit L4TBionic.ini. You're all set with a triple boot system on your Nintendo Switch. Switchroot Android is fantastic for Nintendo DS, PSX, and Dreamcast games, while Ubuntu handles PS2, 3DS, and GameCube games much better. Your custom firmware keeps your Switch games ready to play, and the Reboot to Payload mod lets you quickly return to Hecate whenever you need. If you found this guide helpful, be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications for more Nintendo Switch modding tips. Drop any questions or requests in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you.